Session of explosives. Are there any questions? Yes. After na ma-arrest yung si Rashid sa Bulacan, nagtago siya, no? Nagtago siya. And he thought for a while na akala niya tapos na yung operation. So after na nagtago siya, then pumunta siya sa normal ano siya, pumasok siya sa hospital, kukunin niya yung staff na because he is an X-ray technician there. Doon siya nahuli sa hospital. So he's also a resident of Santa Ana, Bulacan, Bulacan, kagaya ni Rashid. Kasama ba siya?
He's not from Marawi, he's a resident of Bulacan.
Pero yung sa balik Islam.
Yes, a part of the cell that is being used by the Mindanao group. He's part of the cell now operating in northern part of the provinces, Bulacan and nearby provinces, in support of the group of Ansar al-Khalifa in the Philippines.
He has long been here in that taking?
Yes. Yes, he is. But based on information, he has been traveling to and from different places in the south.
Well, number one, we all know that they belong to one cell, no? Since nung umpisa pa lang, alam natin na itong mga to, they belong to one cell and they're about mga lima sa grupo nila. So we're still up going after two of their members.
Sir, anong full name niya, sir? Chief? Sir?
Name?
Sir? Excuse me. Sir, anong full name niya, sir?
His full name is Muhammad Humauas. Muhammad Humauas. Humaudas As. Hindi yung double A-double-S, ha? A-A-S.
L-E-S.
Humaudas As.
Sir, pwede pang i-elaborate niyo, sir, kung paano talaga siya na-aresto? Kailan siya na-aresto? Saan siya nagtago? Parang ganun, sir.
Nagtago siya doon sa Bulacan, Bulacan. He never left the place, actually. After the arrest of Rashid, he never left the place. Nung nakita niya na aresto siya, nagtago siya. And then after, nung namaglal, akala niya hindi na wala ng follow-up operation, that's the time na kukunin niya sana yung kukunin niya yung mga gamit niya dun sa hospital and he's about to flee, no? Dun na siya na nakuha ng ating mga operatiba.
Kailan yun, sir? Kailan?
That's about December 3 na huli, December 3.
Thank you, sir.
Kasama siya doon sa grupo. Kasama siya dito sa tatlo. Remember, nandito siya, eto siya. Part siya na nag-casing doon sa Luneta. At nag-iwan doon sa IED, doon sa Baywalk. Eto siya.
Ay, sir. Sir, may info tayo kung paano naging miyembro ng grupo itong mga to. Kasi parang may trabaho naman siya, sir, di ba? Paano sila na-recruit? Paano?
Well, unang-una, itong mga to, balik Islam ito, no? Before kasi makaging convert ka, may mga indoctrination yan, no? And then they'll brainwash you. Ganun ang ano yan, para kang lumilipat from one religion to another. So you have to believe on what their religion says. Ganun yun. Kaya yung radical mentality, talagang yung bago ka i-convert, kasi parang magiging yung thinking mo magiging radical, kaya ganun. So you see, yun yung ano dyan, kasi there is indoctrination. Remember, from one religion to another, bago ka i-convert dyan, mayroong indoctrination.
Sir, yeah. Gano'n na sila katagal na member ng group?
Around mga 4 years na.
Sir, good morning. Sir, nakikipag-cooperate ba yung suspect sa investigation? So far, may mga nare-reveal na ba siya?
Yes, they're very cooperative. In fact, Rashid have already nagbigay na siya ng extrajudicial confession in front of a assisted by a counsel. No, sinabi na niya lahat yung nalalaman niya.
Can you yeah. divulge something?
Meron na siyang sinabi na niya itong mga grupo niya. Kung, well, yung iba medyo confidential, no? Yung sinabi niya. That's why we still have follow-up operations. And we expect, most probably, hopefully, makuha natin yung isa or dalawa pa na sinasabi nila kasama nila.
Sir, is this
based on his confession.
Is this a cause for alarm? Kasi parang nakakapag-establish sila ng isang cell. So far, isa pa lang, baka meron pang iba pa pala.
Well, itong ginagawa natin, no? That's why we are on full alert, no? Isa yan. That's the isang reason yan kung bakit yun nga sabi ng ating Chief PNP is we are on high security threat level, so that our target hardening measures, which includes, no, yung intelligence gathering natin, yung counter-terrorism operations natin ay ini-strengthen natin. That's the main reason kung bakit tayo naka-full alert, especially the PNP. No, and of course, sila kasi na monitor natin at there are intelligence operatives that are monitoring yung mga ganitong grupo at yung kanilang mga activities.
Sir, isa na lang po kay Colonel Coronel. Sir, you mentioned a while ago about Facebook sa suspect. Paano naging helpful yung Facebook para ma-arrest itong?
Part of the investigation process we made is checking with social media. We know that they are using Facebook and other platforms to disseminate their information, and that is why we're very fortunate that he is registered as a user. That's why you can verify his status and his activities. But of course, we have to check this with our informants on the field. And based on the investigation, we were able to establish his connection with this group of AKP.
Sir, yung sa CCTV muna siya na-identify bago niyo na ano sa Facebook?
No. His name was already part of our persons of interest at the time that we were conducting the operations. And at that time, we did not find out that he was still in Bulacan. We thought he was one of those who already left the area. But then our informants in the field and follow-up operations showed that he was only hiding. And that's why on December 3, we were able to arrest him while he was retrieving his property, his belongings from the hospital and about to flee from the area. Una-una, makikita mo yung pictures niya. Makikita niyo yung pictures niya. In fact, you can see some persons there now who are also part of our investigation. And there are other information which would rather keep it classified at this moment pending results of our follow-up operations. Well, apparently, this is the first time they have been tasked to conduct such mission. As planned by the AKP group in Mindanao. And you will be able to find out in his Facebook account that he has associates or linkages with persons coming from Southern Philippines. So we're exploiting that information now. Okay. That's a possibility we're considering. But at now, we have established that they are connected with the AKP group, Ansal Al-Khalifa in the Philippines. So we'll find out in the coming days if we'll be able to arrest the other members of his cell.
Good morning, sirs. Hi, sirs. Good morning. Sir, ano nangyari dun sa two remaining suspects? May leads na ba? Or yung initial information natin na nakipagbakbakan sila with Maute Group, na-confirm na ba natin yun, sir? Or
yung two other suspects, they're now subject of our follow-up operations. Hopefully, from today until tomorrow, meron tayong maging outcome, no? Output dun sa follow-up operations being conducted by the elements from NCRPO.
But they're still in Mindanao, sir?
Yung isa, sinabi nga nila na bumalik, no? Yung isa, sinasabi nila na bumalik immediately because na-recall daw because of the offensives being conducted by the Armed Forces of the Philippines versus the Maute Group dun sa may Marawi, no? Pero yung isa, we believe na nandito pa sa either dito sa NCR or nearby provinces. Okay. Cavite or yung adjacent provinces dito sa NCR.
Opo. Sir, kanina umaga may nakuhang parang peking IED sa Manila. Meron bang connection ito, sir, or may sa series ng mga threats dito sa Metro Manila? Okay. Are we looking at those things?
At around 6:10 in the morning today, two street sweepers again discovered a suspicious package at University de Manila premises in Tramuros. They brought this package to the Manila City Hall and attempted to surrender it to our civil security force and City Hall detachment, thinking that it might be contained explosive device. And from there, our City Hall detachment called our EOD team, our bomb technicians, who responded to the area. And upon rendering safe procedures and disruption, they found out that it was a bomb hoax or a package which was designed to look like an improvised explosive device. So it poses no danger at all from the very start. We were able to recover certain portions and parts, and which we're trying to investigate right now, who planted that bomb, possibly as a false alarm to divert attention or maybe to as a bomb scare. So that's subject of investigation.
Subject, yes, of the investigation. Pero sir, the street sweepers brought those bombs, yes, using their bare hands, going, yes, to the City Hall.
That's what is scary, actually. That was scary doon. Kaya nataranta yung mga tao doon sa City Hall, no? That should have not been the case. Kasi dapat hindi niya ginalaw yon. Kailangan, sinabi lang niya sa kapulisan natin yon, and then let our EOD K-9 to clear that item, no? Mali yung ginawa nung street sweeper this time, no? Unlike, totally different dun sa ginawa nung nauna, na nireport niya yung nakita niyang suspicious item. Okay. This one, dinala niya. Dinala niya dun sa City Hall, kaya nataranta yung mga tao dun sa City Hall.
Okay, sir, part na yun ng education natin sa public. Because,
yeah, that's part of kaya nga inuulit-ulit natin sa public, sa ating mga kababayan, na if ever nakita silang anything suspicious, any item or any bag, naka-box, na anything suspicious, huwag nilang galawin, no? Pabayaan lang nila, leave it there, and then just inform the authorities, no, or the PNP personnel dun sa pinakamalapit na police station.
Okay. Sir, again, tinitingnan pa natin kung pwedeng interconnected tong mga bagay na ito. Okay. Alright, sir. Thank you.
Kung wala na, thank you and good morning. Yes. Healing Metro Manila. Isolated case lang naman yung mga yan. I'm sure hindi siguro kung talagang legitimate yung police operation, I'm sure walang intention yung ating PNP personnel dyan, no? However, that will be investigated, no? Kung meron talagang pagkukulang yung ating kapulisan dyan, I'm sure they'll be punished or meted administrative punishment and penalty, both criminal at saka administrative dyan. Pardon? Sa operations like here in Metro Manila, no? Ang arrest na nangyari na dito sa Metro Manila is around already 12,000 na. 12,000 na for the past 5 months alone, no? Yung kill dito is like only around less than 2,000. So that's just about 5-6% dun sa nahuhuli, compared dun sa nahuhuli natin. So this is a very small percentage kung compare natin dun sa nahuhuli talaga natin, no? Hindi siguro yung killing rate na sinasabi mo, it's not true. Kasi this is just about 5-6% of compared to the arrest na nagagawa dito sa arrest rate dito sa NCR. So we'll hear it from the lawyer kung if it's unconstitutional or not.
In the absence of any court order, pronouncement or judgment, the presumption of regularity subsists. So we'll follow the operational tokhang until such time it will be considered null and void or void for being unconstitutional.
Yeah, kasi that's plan tokhang is ano namin yun eh, plot of o plan dito sa PNP, no? Will not do anything that is unconstitutional and that violative of the law. So alam naman natin sa PNP yon kung it violates the rights of the people, no? Hindi naman siguro gagawin yung anong yon, yung o plan na yon kung talagang nagba-violate siya ng human rights. Well, voluntary yun eh. Voluntary in nature yun, no? Voluntary in nature. Actually, when we knock on the doors of the public, hindi ka naman papapasukin eh. Doon ka lang sa labas, no? Because you have no warrant. Wala ka naman search warrant, wala kang arrest warrant, no? So, the owners of the house have all the right na hindi ka papasukin talaga. Doon lang naman. Now, if you want to surrender, you'll go to the police station or to the city hall where you'll be made to fill up a form. Ganon. Ngayon, kung yung pumipirma doon sa affidavit, we have a council there na provided by the local government unit pag pumipirma sila ng affidavit. Waiver na pinapasign sa kanila. Yung pinapasign sa kanila is like an undertaking at saka yung personal details nila for monitoring purposes. And that personal details are submitted to the barangay, no? Meron yung barangay, meron yung station, meron yung LGU. So just to monitor their activities. Remember, after they surrender, that doesn't end there, no? Weekly minomonitor sila. Kaya nga yung iba-ibang cities dito sa Metro Manila, they have their own program to monitor itong mga surrenderers natin. Yung iba may Zumba, yung iba may counseling, no? Yung iba naman undergoes training in coordination with TESDA, or yung iba naman nagpo-provide ng livelihood program. Okay, thank you and good morning to everyone.
Thank you again for those who are writing this article. Kindly change the rank of the regional director to police director. Thank you. And you are invited to cover the burning of ranks at 3 p.m. We have some Jayco donuts for you here for your merienda. Thank you.